far away.
Okay. Today we're gonna do the area of trapezoids, rhombuses, and kites to add to what we all did earlier this week. Remember back in chapter 6 that a trapezoid is a quad with two sets of parallel sides? We call the parallel sides the bases. And then the non-parallel sides of a trapezoid are called the legs. The height of a trapezoid is going to be the perpendicular segment that connects the two bases. So on my little diagram there, that dashed line, that's my height. Okay. It's got to be the shortest distance between the two bases. It's going to be perpendicular to the bases. To find the area of a trapezoid, it's 1/2 the height times base 1 plus base 2. However, the previous two worksheets, you were given trapezoids, and you found the area of them without this formula. You cut it into rectangles and triangles. So know that you should be able to find the area of a trapezoid even if you don't know this formula because you've already done it. Okay, you just have to know how to find the area of triangles and rectangles. Cool. So number one, if you don't read your sentence because there's a typo in it and you read mine, a car window is shaped like the trapezoid shown. Find the area of the window. Find your little window on the right side. Area of a trapezoid, 1/2 the height times the sum of the bases. In this window, would the bases be the top and bottom sides or the left and the right? Top and bottom. Good. And the height of our window? So we're going to take 1/2 times 18 times 20 plus 36. I usually like to simplify before I gotta do anything else. So I would take 1/2 of 18. Is 9, and then I can add 20 and 36 and get 56, and then I'd probably throw my calculator here and take 9 times 56. 504?
Yep.
Inches squared. Cool. Number 2. Find the area of trapezoid ABCD. It says, first, draw an altitude from vertex B to DC. This is what you did yesterday on those composite figures. You drew in your own lines to create rectangles and triangles. So we're going to draw in this red line, and that becomes the height of the trapezoid. It also cuts it into a rectangle and a triangle. So if the top of the rectangle is 11, what's the bottom? 11. Therefore, the bottom of my triangle is... good. So what are we going to use to find H? What are we going to use? Pythagorean theorem? Is that what you're going to say? Yeah, the Pythagorean theorem. 5 squared plus H squared equals 13 squared. 25 plus H squared equals 169. Subtract 25 over, h squared equals 144. How do I undo a square? So we get a height of 12. If you want, you could find the area of the rectangle, and then find the area of the triangle and add them together. Or you can use the trapezoid rule, which is 1/2 the height times the sum of the bases. So then that would be 1/2, 12, 11 plus 16. Make sure you get the entire bottom base if you're going to use the trapezoid rule. 1/2 of 12 is 6, and 11 plus 16 is 27, so then we need to take 6 times 27.
No, this is
162.
Good job, Carol. You did it.
Squared.
Sorry, I was not looking at you.
I don't care.
Oh, I thought you were trying to solve.
No, I mean, I was, but I already did this once today. I already know the answers anyway.
Oh,
so sometimes I just pretend like I'm multiplying crisp, but I'm really not.
Boo.
Ooh, it's called wait time. Number 3. Go ahead and try and find the area of the trapezoid. best way to remember all the formulas is to write them down each time you use them. Find the area of a trapezoid, 1/2 height, base 1 plus base 2. You can draw a picture if you need to. Sometimes you don't have to. This one tells me all the information. Height 7, one base is 12, and the other one is 15, correct? So this would be 27, half of 7 is 3.5, so then you have to multiply 3.5 and 27 together to get a total area of 94.5 feet squared, centimeters squared. Okay. Cool. Try the next one. Find the area of trapezoid ABCD. Label your diagrams as much as you can. When you draw in your height, you create a 30, 60, 90 right triangle. So you could use a trig function, sine, cosine, or tangent to find missing sides, or you can use your 30, 60, 90 rules. Opposite of the right angle, this is the hypotenuse. Opposite of the 30, this would be the short leg, which is going to be half the hypotenuse, so that's 9. And then the height is the same as the long leg, so that's the short leg times the square root of 3. So if I use my trapezoid rule, 1/2 height, base 1 plus base 2, then we have 1/2 9 square root 3 times 11 plus 20. Make sure you add the 9 and 11 for the bottom base. If we keep this in radical form, because that's what your worksheet's going to say today, take half of 9, and that's 4.5, and then 11 plus 20 is 31. So then you would just take 31 times 4.5 in the calculator, and then take your square root 3 at the end. Don't put square root 3 in the calculator, because otherwise that's going to give you a wrong answer. Yeah?
Can we just keep doing worksheets for the rest of the quarter?
Wouldn't that be awesome?
Yeah.
Well, when does the quarter end? Does it? If we're not here, will it still end?
No, me either.
Yeah, Scott?
Can I
confuse it when we get to 20?
Yeah.
Because I need the bottom of the whole base.
Oh.
Or the whole trapezoid, so then 9 plus 11. Cool. I don't know what 4.5 times 31 is. And Chris, I don't remember it from earlier.
249.
249?
249.5.
What? Is this for the answer?
Yeah. Just 41.5, or 4.5 times 31.
139.5.
Yeah. Square root 3. Hey, did you put square root 3 in the calculator and round it? Okay, well, I'm putting it in an exact form. That's the difference. With me, Henan? Okay. Cool. Those are trapezoids. Don't forget, they're made up of rectangles and triangles, so you can find the area of rectangles and triangles and add them together. Rhombus. Remember, a rhombus is a parallelogram with 4 equal sides. The diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular to each other, so they form right angles. Yesterday on your worksheet, you had a rhombus. And to find the area of it, you guys found the area of one triangle, and then you took it times 4. So you can always do that. Or, the rhombus formula is 1/2 diagonal times diagonal. So either way, if you remember triangles, you should be good throughout the chapter. But these other ones just make life a little easier. On number 5, to find the area of rhombus RSTU, I'm going to stick with our little special rule today. So 1/2 diagonal times diagonal. We know that one of the diagonals are 24 in length. That's given to us. We have to figure out what the length of the other diagonal is. I'm only going to draw in half of it. So from U to the other diagonal. Diagonals are perpendicular, so they make a right angle. They bisect each other. So this portion here is going to be 12. A rhombus has four congruent sides, so the bottom is going to be 13. So I need to find X. I know you could. When you have a right triangle and you're trying to find the third side, what theorem do we have to use? Pythagorean theorem. So we got to take X squared plus 12 squared equals 13 squared so that I can find that half of the diagonal. Square and subtract, you should get to the point where it says x squared equals 25. Square root both sides, and our x value is 5. Okay, so this half of the diagonal is 5. The other half of the diagonal has to be 5. So the entire diagonal is a length of 10. So now to find the area of the rhombus, you're going to take 1 half 24 times 10. Or 24 times 10 and then divided by 2, should get 120 feet squared. Same idea on the next one. To find the missing diagonal length. You can draw in either half. I would probably draw in the top half here. Diagonals are perpendicular, and they bisect each other. So this guy right here would be 21. And then we have to try and find x. So with the Pythagorean theorem, x squared plus 21 squared equals 29 squared. X squared should equal 400. So then when you square root both sides, what do you get for x? Only got 20. Yeah, okay. So this half is 20. The other half would have to be 20. So that entire diagonal is going to be what? 40. Good. And we already knew that the horizontal diagonal had a length of 42. So then to find the area of a rhombus, 1 half diagonal times diagonal, or you can divide it by 2 there. 840. Millimeters squared. Thanks, Ada. Was that you? Cool. Rhombus. 1 half diagonal times diagonal. That's the same formula for a kite. Okay. Kites, remember, they have adjacent sides congruent, but not opposite sides. They don't have any parallel sides as well. But you can use the same formula for a kite that you can a rhombus. You can flip it over. We don't have an example to the top of the next side. Take 1 half diagonal 1 times diagonal 2. Diagonal 1, the vertical one. How long is that? 5. Good. Diagonal 2, the horizontal one. Has a length of 6. Great. So when I go to find the area, we're going to take 1 half of 5 times 6. Should be 1 half of 30. Which is 15. centimeters squared. Seem too easy? Good. Glad. Wonderful. Try the next one. Find the area of the kite that has diagonal lengths of 12 and 9. One half diagonal. Half 12 is 6, 6 times 9 is 54 inches squared.